My name is K. Annamalai. I'm the Director of Business Development for India Operations for Pericom Semiconductor. We have established a complete sales channel in India. Pericom is involved in signal conditioning, timing, and routing of signals for a variety of customers. And in terms of your question, Pericom has both semiconductors as well as frequency control products. For the semiconductor portion, we are a fabless company, which means we use outside fabs for the CMOS and outside fabs for the BiCMOS process. So we don't stick to one particular foundry. Depending on the needs for high speed or low speed and variety of needs, we will choose whichever fab is applicable for that particular design. So depending on the complexity of the design, we choose the fab house that we work with. And similarly, besides fab, we also use the assembly house, which packages the IC into a full semiconductor. And also, we do the testing. So assembly and testing is also done by a variety of companies in Asia. So as a result, besides design, we outsource a lot of the back-end operations, including fabrication of semiconductors, assembly of semiconductor, as well as the testing of semiconductors. So that's on the semiconductor side. But in addition to the semiconductor side, we also have a frequency control products. Frequency control products are crystals and crystal oscillators. So we have two high-volume manufacturing plants in China and Taiwan to make multiple millions of devices, frequency control devices per month. So there we are vertically integrated. For example, for an oscillator, consists of a crystal blank, it consists of a semiconductor die, and it consists of a sealing, and it consists of the complete packaging. All of these operations are done in-house. As a result, we are able to provide a very cost-effective solution for the oscillators to the market. So we are very vertically integrated for the frequency control. So it's entirely done in-house for the frequency control and outsourced for the ICs. So always there is a desire for high performance and low power. So Pericom makes those products in terms of submicron geometries going down to 0.18 and 0.13 and 90 nanometer devices. So in those case of devices, what is important is low power. As the geometry shrinks, the speed goes up, and the speed goes up, the power also goes up. So we have to have innovative circuitry in the design to lower the power, at the same time meet the performance requirements. So I would say also there is crosstalk as you go down in smaller in geometry. The crosstalk becomes an important factor. So we have to apply some innovation in terms of lowering the power as you go down in geometry. So clocks are the heart of every systems. So for the servers and storage, increasingly, there is a need for high frequency clocks. So we generate using either a clock generator or a crystal oscillator. In those cases, the oscillator needs to be lower in power, or the clock generator needs to be lower in power, and also very low in jitter. So those are the critical things as you design the oscillators for those kind of applications as servers, storage, and networking. So those are the key parameters that we need to watch out for when we design the clocks. Mixed signal design, unlike the VLSI design, is more challenging because you not only need to know the logic design, but also you need to know the transistor level characteristics. So you need to understand how the device behaves. So as a result, it's challenging but innovative, and it takes a lifetime to master the technique of mixed signal design. So Pericom has excellent mixed signal designs for a variety of applications. One of them is the phase lock loop, other is the redrivers, and other is the high-speed signal switching. So for the phase lock loop example, the challenging part is to reduce the jitter and reduce the lockup time. So those two are key parameters for phase lock loop. And for redrivers, the important parameter is the I/O opening at the end of the redriver. Basically, redriver cleans up the input signal, and to clean up the input signal, we have to have the low jitter at the output. So that's a challenge in the redriver. And also high-speed signal switching, the challenge is the lowering the crosstalk, lowering the insertion loss, lowering the return loss, and also lowering the off isolation. So those are the key parameters when we design the mixed signal designs. So those are the key technical challenges when we do mixed signal design. So we cater to a variety of communication platforms. Let's take with the portable applications. For portable applications, we offer a very low power 32 kilohertz oscillators. So those 32 kilohertz oscillators are commonly used in multiple platforms like tablets, a smartphone. Those kind of devices always need some standby power. So in those standby conditions, when there is no activity going on, you need to maintain the clock and you need to maintain the device in a steady state. So in that cases, 32 kilohertz crystal oscillator is commonly used. So in those cases, we need a very tiny, small size crystal oscillator with a very low power and also excellent stability. If you don't maintain the stability, then the oscillator loses the time factor. So as a result, there is an error in the time when you look at the portable devices. So what we need is a low power, a small size, and a precise stability, and we are able to achieve that with our 32 kilohertz oscillator. And besides 32 kilohertz oscillator, we also do a clip sign oscillator. We are the only company in the world doing clip sign oscillators for wireless applications, commonly in a wireless module. Those clock reference is provided by our oscillator, and it's a clip sign to cut down the harmonics at the output. So we have a clip sign waveform, so that enables us to lower the EMI, lower the interference, and comply to the EMI requirements. So Pericom is able to comply to that. So our clip sign oscillators are commonly used in portable applications. So that's one area in communication. The next area in the communication is networking. So in the networking, so we offer a high-speed crystal oscillators and also high-speed clock generators with multiple outputs which are programmable. So what we have in the clock generator is a family called HyFlex clock, so which allows you to program the output frequencies, and there is multiple copies of the different frequencies. So we are able to eliminate multiple crystal oscillators by using one clock generator, and also we are able to eliminate multiple clock buffers by having this HyFlex clock. So this is very popular in a networking space and telecom space like base station applications. So our LC-based PLL clocks called the HyFlex clock is commonly used in the networking applications. So besides that, for networking applications, we have application-specific oscillators, which are oscillators for different standards like 10 gigabit Ethernet or storage. So we have oscillators that are readily available, so customers can know that it is proven in that reference design with an readily available oscillators. So that's one thing that Pericom offers for communications. So besides those oscillators and clock chips, we also offer redrivers for the backplane driving applications in networking. And also we have a packed PCI Express based timing solutions and PCI Express based packet switch solutions for the router market. So those are commonly used in routers in networking. So these are the common elements that we provide for networking and communication markets. So increasingly for the networking standards and storage standards, they are going all the way up to 100 gigabit for Ethernet and up to 12 gigabit for storage. So increasingly data rates are becoming higher and higher. So in those cases, what we need is a clean signal. So you cannot drive far with the one controller chip providing the output. So you need an intermediate redriver circuit to boost the signal and clean up the signal. That's why even within the box and outside the box to drive external cable and inside to drive extra internal PCB, you need a redriver that is commonly used in such applications. So the common standards that need the redriver are PCI Express, USB Super Speed, and SAS, which is up to 12 gigabit, SATA, PCI Express Gen 3, which is 8 gigabit, and DisplayPort, HDMI, all the way up to 5 gigabit. So those are the standards that need these redrivers, both internal to the box and also for external driving applications. Pericom has been pioneering redrivers since 2004. Initially, we started off with redrivers for notebook connectivity applications for external storage. And since then, we have branched off into a lot of different standards. India is witnessing tremendous growth, both for internal consumption as well as for export applications. So a lot of the multinational corporations are establishing major design centers here. And in addition, there are a lot of India design centers which are catering to the OEMs all over the globe. So in addition, India is witnessing a nascent growth in automotive sector, industrial sector like the energy meter and lighting. So there are a lot of, and also set-top box, because the TV is going all digital in India, so there is increasing need for set-top box. So there is tremendous need for electronics, and the forecast is that India will need like $400 billion of worth of electronic products by the year 2020. As a result, Pericom is well positioned in terms of offering innovative products to the market in India. First, we want to approach in a variety of ways. For the multinational corporations that are establishing design centers all over India, we wanted to cater to them with our signal conditioning products and our timing products and also switching products. So we want to hold a variety of technical seminars so that they are aware of our latest products in those specialty areas. So that's one focus. In addition, we also want to focus on the design centers that are across India, like Wipro, HCL, Tata Consultancy, and all of them are having a big hardware design teams, and they also work for the OEMs across the globe. And we also want to do technical seminars and make them aware of what Pericom does. And also, there is a lot of chipset companies like Intel and PMC Sierra, LSI, Freescale, ST, all of them have major design locations here, and we want to participate in the reference design of those companies. And in addition, for the local India design companies which are involved for the India market, like the automotive, set-top box, and those kind of industrial energy meters, those kind of applications also, we want to make them aware of our products, and this can be enabled through writing technical articles in a magazine like EFY, and also talking to EFY correspondents, so we can achieve those goals.